NBC News Channel 11 with a special edition, Attack on America.
America literally under attack. Scenes we never believed we'd ever see. Snapshots like these that you see right here. The scenes that will never be forgotten. A jet hits Tower 1 at the World Trade Center in the heart of Manhattan, New York City. Then 18 minutes later, another jet slams into Tower 2. This exclusive video coming up right here, video that will haunt our nation forever.
What happens when you begin to put the faces with the thousands of people who died this Tuesday?
Those who are missing and their families, this is a tribute to them. We will remember. Excuse me. Whatever you're doing right now, please join us in remembering the thousands who died earlier this week and send a prayer to their families.
Visiting with Senator John McCain this morning, the realization of just how much has changed since September 11th.
Did you ever in your wildest dreams ever expect the World Trade Centers in New York City to be the targets of the attack that they were just a couple weeks ago?
I did not, nor did I believe that the U.S. Capitol was narrowly averted because of the heroism of several young men on board a flight that crashed in Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm. Are we close to having something, some kind of retaliation action?
Well, we know Osama bin Laden and his network are responsible. The question is, did anybody else help him, such as the Iraqis? There's allegations that they gave assistance, and I think there's also other questions as to other nations as well. I think that patience is important here because I think they're planning now a response, but we don't want to do what we did in the past, and that's just launch some cruise missiles and say everything's fine.
Your last quick question. You ran against President Bush in the primaries for the Republican nomination. How's he doing?
Oh, I think he's doing a fine job. He's inspired Americans, and he's leading America, and Americans are supporting him, and I think he's doing a very fine job.
Autumn in New York, thousands from around the world visiting America's biggest city. In Manhattan, on Broadway, the street is closed for nearly a mile, making way for arts and crafts and food. Street dancers perform for tips. Just two blocks away, near 30 Rock, a parade celebrating Polish Americans is underway. In front of one of the many churches in the city. At the Southside Seaport, a boat cruises in front of the Brooklyn Bridge. And in Little Italy, hundreds mill around looking for just the right meal. But with all the vibrance on this fall day, nearby an ominous reminder. A deep pit, a hole in the ground never meant to be. This is Ground Zero, a hallowed place where nearly 3,000 people died on a September morning. Only 30 years old, the two huge 110-story twin towers at the World Trade Center dominated the skyline of Manhattan. Both would be brought down by a terrorist attack.
To imagine the type of devastation we're talking about here at Ground Zero, all you have to do is look at these two towers over here and double them.
Engineers say both towers crumbled because of the heat from the raging fire. Eventually, steel weakened and floors fell on top of each other, the momentum impossible to stop.
After it was hit, it took less than an hour and a half for the building to come down. Now imagine the panic as people hit these streets like burglars to get away.
A full year since the attack, businesses are still reeling.
Can't blame the tourists, but now the tourists aren't buying anything. They're just coming down to pay their respects. So the businesses are not doing well at all in the area.
Across the street, a quarter-mile-long fence with tributes to those who died here. Each Sunday, church groups perform, and many visitors take time to thank New York police or fire department personnel. New York City this autumn is busy, active, full of energy. Proof that life does go on, even with unimaginable tragedy. Jim Heath, NBC News Channel 11, New York. It was another beautiful September morning in New York, but that peaceful image would soon be interrupted as the terrorist attacks on 9/11 changed America forever.
I have spoken to the Vice President. to the governor of New York?
No, I'll never forget that, Jim. I saw the plane hit the first tower, and like everybody else, I wasn't sure what was happening. And then when the second plane hit, I knew immediately that we were under attack. And I called President Bush at that conference in Florida, and we spoke. And I asked him to shut down the airspace over New York, and he said, we're already shutting down the airspace over America.
Often by the side of New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani, Pataki helped the country deal with the deaths of nearly 3,000 innocent people.
There were a line of people waiting out in the soot and the dust and the debris from the towers. And they weren't waiting to get the bus or a subway uptown. They were waiting to give blood.
And what about the man responsible for organizing that attack that killed so many?
I want him help. I want justice. And there's an old poster out west, as I recall, that said, wanted, dead or alive.
As the governor of the state of New York, what do you say to the families of all those victims? Have they had justice yet?
Jim, of course not. And I don't know that you can ever have justice for a horrible, barbaric attack like that. And certainly we're going to have disappointments, like the fact that we still have not got Osama bin Laden. But regardless of what it takes, the war on terror is something we have to prevail in.
It's here where we're invited to spend an inning of baseball in the stands, reminiscing about 9/11 and the World Series that followed just weeks later.
The World Series is being played between Arizona and New York, but being played for and in honor of the American people.
Baseball went a long way to helping America heal in 2001, didn't it?
It sure did. It did a lot for me. I mean, it was the only thing, baseball games and my son's high school football games were the only things that got my mind off all the terrible things we were dealing with and the tremendous pressure of it and how to comfort people, how to do the best you could to recover as many people as you could and get the city back to a normal way of thinking. So when I'd watch baseball, it would remind me life is going to go back to normal.
Ironically, you and Senator McCain actually sat together, right? You
we
sat
sure
together.
Did.
Would you have ever dreamed that 5 or 6 years later, both of
no.
you would be leading the
no,
pack?
John continues to be a very good friend, and we watched Game 6 and Game 7 together.
Right.
We had a bet on it. He won that bet.
McCain's Diamondbacks would beat Giuliani's Yankees in 7 games, but everyone agreed that baseball helped America get back on its feet.
Feels right to be back here at the ballpark.
But a lot of South Carolinians got to know Rudy Giuliani on that fateful day. What do you remember? Is it something that you'll remember for the rest of your life?
Every day. Every day of my life, I remember it. I remember parts of it every day of my life.
Put your mask on. Put your mask on.
Sometimes it's the very sad parts and the very tragic parts, and sometimes it's the very brave and unbelievably wonderful things that people did, the tremendous spirit they had. So it's a mixture of very bad memories and very good memories, you know, very uplifting memories of heroism. And then, you know, seeing people 20 minutes before they died or seeing some of the horrible things that happened to people when things were falling off the building or people jumping off the building. Different memories, and I've learned that I'm going to think of it every day of my life, and I just try to say thank God that America got through it, and I believe we're strong enough for it.
Nearly six years later, Osama bin Laden. I mean, a lot of people, we've not had justice for a lot of people.
It's something that I also think about every day. I think it's very, very important that in addition to everything else we're doing in the war on terror, that we catch it. I think we have to crush Al-Qaeda because they were the ones responsible for it, the Taliban. And then, you know, it really is important that we not lose sight of the fact that we have to catch bin Laden and bring him to justice.
Now reelected to her second term to represent New York in the Senate, Clinton is still bothered that Osama bin Laden, the mastermind behind 9/11, remains on the run.
Well, it bothers me greatly, and I've been to Afghanistan 3 times, just as I've been to Iraq 3 times. And on each of my trips to Afghanistan, I have sought out the best advice I could get from people on the front lines in that country, Pakistan, our military, because for the life of me, I don't understand why bin Laden is basically at large. And we had some reports today that clearly he is funding some of the training camps that are sending the Taliban and Al-Qaeda fighters across the border to do battle with our NATO forces and with the new Afghan army. So this is a very serious matter. I would never have diverted attention from Afghanistan and the hunt for bin Laden until we'd gotten the job done, and I'd like to see it done now.